exchange reaction occurs when two ionic compounds switch ionic partners. Here I've written out the full molecular reaction equation for the exchange reaction between barium chloride and silver nitrate. On the product side, they've switched ionic partners. Silver is now with chloride, and barium is now with nitrate. I can represent the same reaction in two other ways. This is the ionic reaction equation, where each soluble compound is broken into its constituent ions. Here the aqueous labels are omitted for clarity. Notice silver and chloride remain together because silver chloride is insoluble, which I know from checking my solubility table. In the ionic reaction equation, I can see that some ions show up on both sides of the equation. These are spectator ions, which means they don't participate in the reaction. To write a simplified version of this reaction, I can simply exclude the spectator ions to obtain the net ionic reaction equation. This particular equation can be further simplified since every reagent now has the same coefficient. You can often predict when a reaction will occur if there appears to be a driving force. Here are a few examples of driving forces you might encounter. A precipitation of an insoluble solid, the evolution of a gas, or an acid-base neutralization, like the KHP titration. In this experiment, you're asked to combine several pairs of chemicals and predict if a reaction will occur. I'll demonstrate with zinc chloride and silver nitrate. The molecular reaction equation for these compounds looks like this. By consulting my solubility table, I can see that silver chloride is insoluble. Mixing the two chemicals results in a cloudy white precipitate. In my notebook, I'll record a table like this, including the ionic and net ionic reaction equations. As stated earlier, the driving force here is the precipitation of silver chloride. The contents of the tube are rinsed into the provided waste container. This process is repeated with all the pairs of chemicals listed in the procedure.